Welcome. On behalf of the Greater Lowell Technical School Committee and our faculty and staff, I would like to extend a warm welcome to our graduating seniors, their families, and our invited guests. My name is Roger Bourgeois, and I have the honor to serve you as the superintendent of the Greater Lowell Regional Technical School District. Our commencement exercises are the highlight each year, and we are very happy that you were with us this evening to share this important celebration of student success for the class of 2015. Please remain standing as we honor our country with the playing of our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming? Whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in the air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, see, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free? And the home of the
Please be seated. And I'd ask you to join me. I'd ask you to join me with another round of applause for our musician, Mr. Ralph Furano. At this time, I'd like to recognize and introduce our platform guests. To my far right in the front row, please welcome Paul Morin, school representative from Draycott. George O'Hare, school committee representative from Lowell. Also representing the city of Lowell, Ray Booten. And our assistant superintendent and principal, Jill Davis. And our class valedictorian, Kristen Sylvester. And continuing to my left, across the front row, Lanisa Paul, class salutatorian. And our commencement speaker this evening, and the president and owner of Mill City Environmental Corporation, Mr. Brian Chapman. And representing the school committee from the city of Lowell, Fred Bahu. And school committee member representing the town of Draycott, Joe Espinola. And our school committee representative from the town of Tingsboro, George Tatsios. And also from the city of Lowell, our school committee representative, Curtis LeMay. And starting again on my far right, our second row, please welcome our senior class advisor, Valerie Franco. Our 10th ranked student this year, Carla Marbelt. And ranked 9th in the class of 2015, Deborah Kamau. 8th ranked student, Sasha Silva. 7th ranked student, Jennifer Say. And our 6th ranked student, Angela Philavong. And ranked 5th in the class, Kayla Kohansky. 4th ranked student, Jocelyn Cox. And our 3rd ranked student, Tamaris Farrier. And our other senior class advisor, Andrea Malleroy. And at this time, it is my pleasure to introduce to you the second highest ranked student in the class of 2015 to deliver the salutatory address, Lanisa Paul.
Good evening. On behalf of the graduates that sit before me this evening, I would like to thank those here tonight. Fred Bahu, the chairman of the school committee, his fellow committee members, Superintendent Roger Bourgeois, Assistant Superintendent Principal Jill Davis, administrators, teachers, commencement speaker, Mr. Brian Chapman, family, friends, and guests. This is our last official class meeting. But it won't be about discipline, news, or caught doing good. Rather, it is time to share our excitement about finishing high school and starting a new chapter of our lives. Today, we reminisce, recognize, and reflect on the past 4 years at Greater Lowell. William Shedd said, "A ship is safe in harbor, but that's not what ships are for. You will never know what's out there unless you set sail." I encourage you all to take a healthy risk. Try something different and go out of your comfort zone. As a class, we have taken many risks and have finally reached our first milestone, high school graduation. Congratulations, class of 2015. We took a risk when we made our first choice to begin our high school education in a technical high school without knowing what was ahead for us. We chose Greater Lowell Technical High School. 4 years ago, we were freshmen that walked into foreign territory with middle school swagger. As embarrassing as it is to look back, something else amazing happened. Our laughter echoed across the halls, and friendship was forged among peers and teachers. We turned the unfamiliar halls of Greater Lowell into our beloved home. Our next risk was choosing our exploratory shops. Many of us came here believing we knew exactly which shops we would choose for our career path. Some of us stuck with that choice and some did not. We learned that by trying out different shops, we either made the right selection or the wrong selection. We learned that it's okay to take a risk and to try something new. For all of us, that risk became an opportunity to find a shop that we fit into. Sophomore year, we lived in the moment. We picked a shop that we thought fit our individual criteria. We did not know whether we truly liked it or not until we experienced it. Did the sound of cutting sheet metal inspire us in metal fabrication? Did we like the feeling of making someone else happy by making them feel beautiful in cosmetology? We all took a risk. At first, making a simple French braid seemed impossible, but through practice, perseverance, and patience, I got the swing of it, and shop was much more exciting. I learned that my success was dependent on my effort. What I really learned that year was the fact that I was in control of how successful I would be. I have had to work hard and give all my effort in order to stand here before you today. Each one of us learned that through hard work and learning to take healthy risk, we can accomplish anything. Before we knew it, we were juniors and considered ourselves experts in our shops. We knew the routine, the expectations, and the challenges. We thought we were experts, but the reality was that there was much more to learn. Just because we passed MCAS did not mean we could rest. There was still so much that needed to be accomplished. Senior year came, and during that first week of senior year, we tried to declare to ourselves and our teachers that we were done, done growing up and ready to graduate. Our teachers smiled and began the enormous task of keeping us focused and helping us through the many applications, college, scholarships, and employment applications. Again, we took risks. We joined clubs, joined teams, and joined Skills USA. We solidified old friendships, we made new friendships, and began to believe that our dreams when we came here were definitely a possibility. We now have the tools and knowledge to succeed. Alone, we could not accomplish this journey. We are indebted to the people that supported us. Our teachers endured more than what we have. They memorized the names of each and every one of their students. Think about it for a moment. We learned to deal with maybe 15 to 20 different teachers with different personalities. Our history, math, and English teachers have to deal with hundreds of students. That's hundreds of different personalities. They helped us decipher the hieroglyphics of new material onto pages of notes to help us understand and eventually succeed. The result of this combined work between us and them is us standing here graduating. Our families never, never gave up on us. They all took a risk to have faith in us. Just like our teachers, they believed in us. Because of them, here we are now, covered in an accomplished glow. Thank you for sharing this moment with us. Life is either a daring adventure or nothing at all. As Helen Keller once said, be daring, take an unfamiliar route, and see where it takes you. After all, we make our own adventures. So what do you say, class of 2015? Are you ready for the world? Thank you.
It is an honor and a privilege to address you this evening at the 41st commencement exercises in honor of the class of 2015. I offer my sincere congratulations to the graduates as you celebrate this significant milestone in your lives, your graduation from high school. It also gives me great pleasure to extend my congratulations to the loving parents, guardians, and family members who have played such important roles in the success of the young men and women who we honor here this evening. You should be very proud of your graduate and what he or she has accomplished. as well as the countless contributions that you have made to ensure his or her success. I would also like to take this opportunity to express my thanks to the faculty and staff of our school, who work so hard each day to create an environment that is conducive to the learning and growth of every student. They are dedicated and committed professionals who take great pride in the accomplishments and success of our students. I'm also grateful to the school committee, for they provide the leadership to maintain a school that truly seeks to put the needs of the students above all others. We are most fortunate to have a committee that cares very deeply about the mission and the core values of our vocational technical high school. They bring an enormous depth and breadth of experience to their positions, as they are highly regarded professionals as well as elected public servants. They serve tirelessly and without compensation, and give freely of their time and expertise to ensure that every student receives the best educational experience possible. At this time, I would like to take a moment to share a quote with our graduates from an individual who lived a long time ago. He was a printer by trade, but achieved most of his fame as a scientist. And some would actually argue that he was the first electrician. All would agree that he significantly changed the world we live in. The quote is from Benjamin Franklin. And Benjamin Franklin once said, "He that hath a trade hath an estate." How appropriate for graduates of a technical high school who have complemented their academic studies with a comprehensive career-focused education in one of 23 different technical majors. 214 of you have already experienced employment success through participation in the cooperative education program. Many of you have demonstrated technical skill proficiency through district, state, and national SkillsUSA competitions. And some of you have already acquired valuable licenses, credentials, and certifications recognized nationally by industry and locally by several state boards of professional licensure. So my message for you today, as you graduate as a member of the class of 2015, is inspired by Benjamin Franklin's quote. You have a trade. You have begun a journey at Greater Lowell Tech to acquire and master the skills necessary for successful careers in the 21st century workforce. You can have an estate if you continue to pursue your chosen career path while constantly working to grow and develop as craftsmen, technicians, or professionals. I know that I speak on behalf of everyone gathered here this evening to honor you when I tell you that we are all very proud of you and what you have accomplished. Congratulations, class of 2015. This time, it's my honor to introduce our commencement speaker. Brian Chapman is the president and owner of Mill City Environmental. He grew up in the Centralville section of Lowell and graduated from Lowell Public Schools. He went on to attend the University of Massachusetts at Amherst, where he earned his degree in geology. Brian then spent 15 years working in environmental services field for Fortune 100 companies Foster Wheeler and Clean Harbors. In 2001, he started his own company, Mill City Environmental, and has grown it into an award-winning firm with 46 employees serving clients in 17 different states. In 2014, last year, Brian was recognized as the Lowell Sun Man of the Year for giving back to the city that raised him. In 2013, his company was recognized by the Environmental Business Journal and received their Business Achievement Award for a complex remediation project that they completed on the USS Cass & Young, a destroyer that was harbored in the Charlestown Navy Yard. In 2012, Brian was recognized by the National Small Business Association as their Minority Small Business Person of the Year, not only just for Massachusetts, but for all of New England. Brian is actively engaged in dedicating time to give back to his community, because he believes that it has given so much to him. As a result, he currently serves on the board of directors for the Greater Lowell Boys and Girls Club, the Lowell Parks and Conservation Trust, and the Lowell Collegiate Charter School. Please give a warm Greater Lowell Tech welcome to our commencement speaker, Mr. Brian Chapman.
Welcome, thanks for being here. Let me get out of your way.
First of all, that was an amazing introduction because I've never heard all that stuff rattled off before, and being a humble guy from Lowell, I was just, it's amazing what you can do with a little help, but I just want to say Superintendent Bourgeois, Assistant Superintendent Davis, faculty, members of the school committee, valedictorian Kristen and salutatorian Lanisa, family and friends of graduates, ladies and gentlemen of Greater Lowell Technical High School class of 2015. I want to thank you for the privilege of speaking to you this evening. I'm honored and grateful. Thank you. As I stand here before you looking over the class of 2015, I see myself. 35 years ago, to the date yesterday, I enjoyed my commencement ceremony here in the city of Lowell. I was excited, ready to take on Lowell, the Merrimack Valley, the world. The sky was the limit. And during that night, I could hear, "This is your time. Capture the moment. Build on it." I wanted to bottle up the joy, excitement, and love that I felt that evening, so at some point I could have it available later in life, during those times when storm clouds of doubt, fear, loneliness, and disappointment would creep in. As I found out later in life, that you actually have that bottle, and in the bottle are the friendships, the acquaintances that you have forged during your 4 years at Greater Lowell Technical High School. Don't ever lose them. The faculty, the staff, the people that are proud to help you get through your 4 years of school, to help launch a lifetime of success, that is what's in that bottle. Those people are an important part of you and will help you in ways you can't measure as you continue on your journey in life. One of the important things as I grew up is finding a mentor. Finding a mentor, whether it's a faculty member, a counselor at a local club, a parent of a good friend, is invaluable. And at a point when you can be a mentor, be one. Give back. And I've been lucky enough to be able to give back to the community that I grew up in, that has held me high, and that has helped me attain what I've done today. One of my favorite stories and place that I really hold deep and dear to my heart is the Greater Lowell Boys and Girls Club. The Greater Lowell Boys and Girls Club, when I first attended, was just the boys' club. There, I learned self-confidence, learned to get along with others that didn't look like me, and built friendships that to this day have been solid as gold. The counselors and the people at the boys' club were loving, caring, and would help you through that journey at the club. Now, one of the other things about your journey is dreaming big. Always dream big. when the naysayers, negative people, the Eeyores out there want to bring you down with negativity, don't let it affect you. They will say why, you will say why not. Now, one of my favorite quotes is from J.K. Rowling, who made that one, wrote those wonderful books, Harry Potter. And she said, "It is impossible to live without failing at something, unless you live your life so cautiously that you might as well not have lived at all, in which case you fail by default." And in a nutshell, your life journey, there'll be many ups and downs. There will be failures, there will be successes, but do not have fear of failure, because that will make you stronger. That will help bring your dream closer. Now, as I had mentioned, I've had several mentors in my life, and one of the important things also is your family. I'm one of four boys. My mother was one of 12 kids. My dad was one of six. And that is a very important thing to help keep you anchored. So always hold your family close to you. And in closing, I would like to go over my top 10 list of pointers to the class of 2015. At number 10 is, life must be fun. Kindness is essential. Have a good time. Hurt as few people as possible. Number 9, be bold. Be prudent. You have to take risks. Number 8, smile, laugh, and be pleasant every single day. Number 7, be strong enough to say, I don't know. Everybody will try to say, well, I can figure it out, but if you don't know, you don't know. Makes you a better person. Number 6, life is too hard to be lived alone. Find time for your family and friends. Number 5, stay in touch with the people who matter to you. Very important to do. You can always take a minute to send a text or an email. Number 4, hold within yourself a capacity for outrage and injustice. If you see something wrong or someone that has been wrong, don't be afraid to speak up about it, because some people just need a helping hand and a voice to help out. Number 3, don't be colorblind. Enjoy the enriching differences and the diversity of your community. Number 2, seek balance. A rich life is a balanced life as you get out into the workforce between work and family. And first of all, help people along the way. Congratulations, the graduating class of 2015.
Now it is my pleasure to introduce to you the number 1 ranked student in the class of 2015 to deliver the valedictory address, Kristen Sylvester.
Welcome, friends and family of the class of 2015. I'd like to take a moment to thank Fred Bahu, chairman of the school committee, and his colleagues, our Superintendent Roger Bourgeois, Assistant Superintendent Principal Jill Davis, administrators, teachers, parents, and guidance counselors, for all of their hard work and encouragement. You have inspired us in many ways while helping us to prepare for this exciting day. Thank you, Brian Chapman, for taking the time to speak with us today. Finally, I'd like to say a formal congratulations to the graduating class of 2015. Here we are. 4 years of memories are now part of our past. No matter who we were in high school, we are all looking forward to the future. In truth, the future can be frightening. Thinking about the time ahead of us, we often ask questions like, who will I be? What will I do? How can I suddenly transform into an adult when I've been playing the role of a child my whole life? Really, no one knows the answers to these questions. Unlike the tests we've been taking, there is no answer key to the test of life. And although not having the answers may seem scary, It also means there is no right or wrong way to live your life. Each of us has our own path, whether you're leaving here with college plans, enlisting in the military, entering the workforce, or taking some time to decide, I say go on with confidence. Know that no matter where you go in life, it's your unique path. We have so much freedom and so many opportunities ahead of us. Make the choices that feel right for you. Go where you want to in life. You only live it once. I conclude with a quote from screenplay writer Eric Roth. For whatever it's worth, it's never too late or too early to be whoever you want to be. You can change or stay the same. There's no rules to this thing. I hope you make the best of it. I hope you live a life you're proud of. If you find you're not, I hope you have the courage to start all over again. Thank you, Greater Lowell, and good luck to the class of 2015.
And now please join me in welcoming to the podium the chair of our school committee, Mr. Fred Bahu.
Thank you for everybody for showing up here tonight. Thank you, Kristen, for a great delivery of a great speech. Thank you, Brian, for giving this your best effort and really working hard to let the kids know what you have to offer and what they have to offer moving forward. And thank you for Lanisa for really working hard to probably becoming number one student, however, being a great number two student. Superintendent Bourgeois, Assistant Superintendent Davis, fellow school committee members, faculty, staff, parents, grandparents, family, and friends, it is my pleasure to present you the 2015 Greater Lowell Technical High School graduating class. Congratulations. I would also like to acknowledge former members of this school committee, David Tully, who served Greater Lowell Technical High School for 20 years, and former school committee member Eric Gitchier, whose motion to hold the first graduation here at the Tsongas Center was unanimously voted by the school committee who humbly sits before you. Congratulations, class of 2015, for this first of graduating out of the Tsongas Center. I'm sure you're very comfortable in your seats. Class of 2015, always remember, when one door closes, another one opens up. So now you've completed your high school education. Now what? First, always put your best foot forward. Educate yourself even more. Set goals for yourselves. And although those goals may not be met, by meeting some and setting more, you will always be moving up the ladder of success. The whole idea is to always progress positively. As my friend, Dean Fallon, always says to me, Freddie, he says, you need to reach for the stars. Class of Greater Lowell Tech 2015, upon walking out here tonight, you will always be alumni of Greater Lowell Tech. Cherish it. It's your personal accomplishment. And please stay involved with the school and the underclassmen and the previous graduates. This is your legacy. Most importantly, join together. Many of you are going to become business leaders, homeowners, and community activists. And if you use the resources you have, which are your fellow alumni, your opportunity and growth potential will be limitless. Work together. Graduates, keep investing in yourselves and in your communities. Whatever it is, volunteering at the Y or at the Boys Club, the Wish Project, which I've seen many of you at, the local park, the church, or just breathing some life into someone you know having a difficult time. You can make a difference. In closing, I'd like to use a quote, as other people have here before me. And the quote is from President John F. Kennedy, stated in his inaugural address in 1960. John F. Kennedy said, "It's not what your country can do for you, but it's what you can do for your country." So always remember, you can benefit others just by being who you are. Be your best, do your best, and help others to their best potential. Congratulations, class of 2015.
And now, the moment that we've been patiently waiting for. Assistant Superintendent and Principal Jill Davis will begin the conferring of diplomas.
Good evening, everyone. I am honored and privileged to be here and very proud to announce the graduates of Greater Lowell Technical High School, class of 2015. I'd like to begin with our top 10 students. The number one ranking student and class valedictorian, Kristen C. Sylvester. The number two ranking student and class salutatorian, Lenisa S. Pohl. The number three ranking student, Tamaris M. Faria. The number four ranking student, Jocelyn M. Cox. The number five ranking student, Kayla D. Kohansky. The number sixth ranking student, Angela C. Filavong. The number seventh ranking student, Jennifer Say. The number eighth ranking student, Sasha R. Silva. The number ninth ranking student, Deborah W. Kamau. The number 10th ranking student, Carla J. Marbelt. Angel L. Acevedo. Brianna L. Aguilar. Jason F. Allegresso. Selena Alvarado. Isaac Andrade. Kayla Angove. Mia Anton Georgi. Ashley Orchinsky. Caitlin Arsenault. Jessica L. Arsenault. John G. Ash. Christopher Z. Avila. Natasha D. Aviles. Ramon A. Abar. Thomas J. Ayotte Jr. Israel Baez. Franil G. Batista. Kirsten E. Basdanis. Margot F. Beauchamp. Nevin R. Beaudry. Brandon R. Bellarose. Chanel V. Bellarose. Ricardo T. Benitez. Tiffany M. Benoit. Joseph P. Bergeron. Brandon M. Betancourt. Jessica H. Betancourt. Stacy C. Bilodeau. Danielle R. Blaisdell. Denise E. Blyer. Destiny D. Bow. Fidelia Boachi. Joseph M. Boudreau. Kelsey L. Booten. Caitlin C. Bow. Nicole C. Bray. Miranda S. Brooks. Gage E. Briette. David W. Brown. Michael J. Brunel, Jr. Dylan M. Burdick. Brenna M. Burton. Poonlu R. Booth. Autumn M. Caldwell. Samantha R. Campbell. Mark F. Caplice. Leo J. Carbono III. Jonathan T. Carroll. Julian A. Caracini. Rocco F. Carter IV. Alicia M. Castillo. Victoria L. Castro. Lucy Salado. Brianna Chason. Chumren J. Chan. Lily V. Chan. Kikiana A. Chow. Petra Chap. Gloria D. Charlie. Stephanie S. Chia. Takira M. Chan. Sothia Che. Vuthi P. Chun. Sabrina M. Chung Kong. Alexia V. Chim. Amanda L. Chin. Brandy Chun. Kyle C. Christman. Gabriella T. Salaki. Christopher Serino. Valerie E. Clayton Walter Ding. Allison M. Clough. Abigail Correa. Lauren E. Cody. Monica L. Kupal. Courtney L. Coviello. James R. Crawford. Brittany R. Croto. Gabriella M. Cruz Gonzalez. Jocelyn M. Cruz. Katiana M. Cruz. Jacqueline M. Cutter Lee. Tiffany S. Dunn. Tanya M. DeRosha. Darielle K. Da Silva. Antonio J. Da Silva. Matthias S. DeFarius. Matthias F. D'Souza. Joseph P. DeBrum. Zeta N. De Jesus. Kayla M. De La Paz. Michelle M. Del Carmen. Kiara Y. Delgado. Danielle E. Del Rossi. Matthew S. Dennison. Callie M. DeRosias. Alejandra R. Diaz. Christian E. Diaz. Dennis A. Diaz. Thalianette I. Diaz. Michael J. DeMoro. I'd like to call to the stage graphic communication instructor Rainey Dion to present the diploma to his son, Joseph R. Dion. Thomas P. Dion. Jean C. Disla. Alyssa M. Dougherty. Erica M. Dom. Emily H. Donovan. Stephanie A. Donovan. Sophia Du. Brandon I. Duongville. Ryan T. Doyle. Stephen M. Doyle. Francisco A. Ducasse. Jacqueline A. Dufault. Alexandria M. Dufresne. Courtney A. Dumont. Ryan J. Dunn. Shanae L. Durham. Alex E. Hannah R. Eastman. Alexa L. Eaton. Manuela A. Echeves. Monica Eck. Christopher K. Emond. Miranda K. N. Cole A. Enos. Sarah M. Arrett. Joshua D. Espinola. Brandon Marcus A. Fabrez. Matthias F. Ferrara.
Sorry.
Janaris I. Figueroa. Megan Y. Fitz. Ecstasy M. Flores. Jamie Lee Flynn. I'd like to call to the stage school committeeman, Mr. Ray Booten, to present the diploma to Thomas D. Foley. Ann Fontaine. Jacqueline L. Fontanez. Maria Luisa Fontanez. Kyle B. Foote. Justin J. Forestier. Andrea L. Forrestal. Amber L. Forsyth. Leslie I. Fortunato. Caitlin M. Fornia. Ashley T. Frecker. Christine A. Fundakowski. Kiera M. Gagne. Rebecca A. Gantz. Kyla I. Garay. Jason L. Garboski. Matthew A. Garcia. Neva A. Garcia Cintron. Victoria L. Gates. Rosemary W. Gadesha. Christopher A. Gaudet. Daniel J. Gaudet Jr. Anthony S. Gendron. Jared T. Jeffroy. Nicholas M. Jeffroy. Evan C. Georgiadis. Sam Georgiusis. Kyle W. Gilbert. Stefania Helraldo. Ruben Gathinji. Amber T. Gonzalez. Angel L. Gonzalez. Damian D. Gonzalez. Devin A. Gonzalez. Brandon P. Gordon. Sarah E. Gorski. Emily J. Graham. Caitlin L. Graham. Cheyenne A. Green. Daniel T. Griffin. Bridget R. Hadley. Mona High. Aaliyah R. Hale Bennett. Benjamin M. Hall. Jessica V. Hall. Jonathan Hall. Caleb T. Hansen. Renee Harris. Michael J. Hebert. Amanda M. Hem. Lindsay M. Hanault. Teresa T. Hang. Christina Henriquez. Christian A. Hernandez. Leonel Hernandez. Jessica R. Hike. Stephen S. Hilson. Nika D. Height. Nicole H. Hoffman. James T. Hoffman Castricone. Diane W. Hong. Dominique L. Horn. Edward Holson. Jacob N. Hudzik. Noah E. Hudzik. Austin Huertes, Mara C. M., Melina V. M., Saray V. M., Matthew J. Janda, Tatiana E. Jaramello, Jania M. Jean, Caleb D. Jeffrey. I'd like to call to the stage electrical teacher Mr. Brian Jones to present the diploma to his daughter Jody M. Jones. Nathalia B. Justo. Onita D. Camavanza. Kevin S. Kahn. Jacob R. Kapala. James M. Karimi. I'd like to call to the stage metal fabrication teacher, Mr. Tom Keslowski. To present the diploma to his son, Justin T. Keslowski. And his daughter, Michaela L. Keslowski. Cindy R. Keith. Victoria A. Keene, Jake T. Kelly, Alexis N. Kelly, Michael P. Kenyon, Anthony S. Keeve, Robbie F. Kim, Belinda M. Korn, Katharina T. Keehan, Kevin Kim, Tracy W. Kimani, Vincent H. Kirathi, Daniel T. Kitchens, Andrew S. Kun, Kelly J. Cubitt, Emily M. Kurz, Tyler R. Labonte, Deanna M. Labreck, Lucretia M. Latch, Jonathan T. LaFlamme, Christopher A. LaFond, Sean P. LaJoy, Alyssa M. LaMarche, Nicholas E. Langlois, Kathleen C. LaRoe, Sarah E. Largy, Nicole M. Lauren, Shane M. Lavoy, Alexander C. Lay, Chan J. Lay, Lillian P. Lay, Wendy Lazaro, Visna Lee,
thank you.
Okay. John D. Leahy. Joshua A. LaBelle. Michael R. LeBlanc. Kendra L. LeClaire. Caitlin M. Late. Christopher J. Leakis. Fabian O. Leon. Sean D. Lessier. Christopher J. Letourneau. Amy N. Levesque. Michael J. Lima. Louis B. Lorenzo. Anissa M. Livingston. Joshua L. Livingston. Alexis E. Luce. Milena K. Lucio. J. Cole Lewis Marquise. Alex P. Lee. Sabrina M. Lish. Lindsay M. McFadden. Kelsey N. Machado. Ryan J. McKay. Faith R. McKenzie. Sean M. Mahoney. Stacy L. Maley. Carla M. Mandeville. Kayla.
Sorry.
Michelle L. Mandeville. Ashley Manorin. Adamas Maria Tejeda. Andrew S. Marquis. Cindy Marte. Brock A. Martin. Michael J. Matamoros. Crystal M. Matos. Nishali Matos. Jolene T. McDonald. Henry J. McDonough. Courtney C. McLaughlin. Taylor L. McLaughlin. Christopher McMahon. Jada L. McMenamin. Brianna C. McNeil. Melinda S. Meach. Miguel A. Medina. Melissa Medina. Brian J. Melanson. Joseph M. Mendonca. Lexis K. Menzies. Nathaniel D. Mercado. Kimberly A. Merced. Laura C. Mesa Garcia. Nicholas P. Metros. Vincent D. Moo. Alexandra L. Mouchard. Bailey M. Millett. Alexia D. Millman. Megan E. Mills. Stephen D. Misitano. Tyler J. Mitchell. Kayla M. Molina. Idalis A. Montserrat. Gabriella Y. Montalvo. Erica M. Montez. Cassidy S. Monty. Roberto Morales, Brandon J. Morlock, Evan C. Mosley, Veronica W. Mukundi, Tyler G. Murphy, Abby P. Muwanji, Mary N. Mora, Elizabeth M. Nato, Amina Nanyando, Marissa A. Napolitano, Christian D. Nascimento, Nikki Nath, Leah W. Dungo, Roy Lee Neese, Laerte R. Neto, Zipporah N. Ganga, Annie N. Guji,
Boogie,
Ricky Nguyen, John S. Nicolades, Kelsey A. Nobrega, Calvin V. Nomau, Premer N. Simbambi, Dayanara M. Nunez, Josefina A. Nunez, Kalechi B. Obika, Joseph P. Ogden, Calvin Onseving, Adrian Opio, Alex R. Ortiz, Fabiola E. Ortiz, Giovanni E. Ortiz, Rafael D. Ortiz, Kara E. Owen, Brianna Y. Padilla Berrios, Jaylene M. Pagan, Haralambos J. Pangiotopoulos, Sovanari Pan, Nicole L. Paquette, Adriana N. Paquin, Nicole E. Paquin. I'd like to call to the stage school committeeman Mr. Curtis LeMay to present the diploma to Morgan L. Parent. Alex W. Park, Julio A. Pastrana, I'd like to call to the stage school committeeman Mr. Ray Booten to present the diploma to his nephew Anthony R. Patnaud. Precious K. Paulino, Robert J. Perry, Stephanie L. Perry, Shelby L. Peterson, Julia Fay, Angelo P. Pilato, Talia M. Pimentel, Barilyn J. Pineda, David A. Poitras. Kenny Pop. Jasmine P. Prack. Anthony P. Previtt. Andrew J. Primo. Alyssa R. Prue. Jagger T. Prue. Patricia Ramirez. Angel L. Ramos. Xavier Ramos. Joshua S. Rigo. Dion R. Wren. Mateo Restrepo. Christopher L. Reyes. Michael D. Ricard. Tyler J. Riley. Marcus A. Rios. Jacob H. Rivera. Miguel A. Rivera. Sierra R. Roberts. Kaylee A. Robles Damaris. Avanya C. Rodriguez. Emery Rodriguez. George A. Rodriguez. Nadia R. Rodriguez. Nelson A. Rodriguez III. Sienna N. Rodriguez. Sebastian Rojo. Zoli J. Rollins. Stephanie P. Romeo. Destiny L. Rondon. Trevor D. Roper. Vivian T. Rosado. Hillary B. Rosario. Jamie Rosario. Avery Rossino. Timothy L. Roos. Ricky A. Ruthia Paquette. Heriberto Ruiz. Wesley Ruski. Tyler T. Rutina. Shannon E. Ryan. Michael A. Raye. Emerlina K. San. Angel A. Sanchez. Alexander Santiago. Angel D. Santiago. Anthony B. Santiago. Daniel K. Santos. Davi Saar. Betsy N. Saravia. Timothy C. Sav. Brittany R. Savage. Joseph R. Schlake. Mark A. Severius. Giovanna B. Shannon. Kevin F. Sheehan. Brittany K. Shoemaker. Jennifer D. Sheehan. Putali Siavong. Alicia M. Silva. Brianna I. Silva. Mario J. Silva, Jr. Rachel R. Silva. Alexis M. Silvar. Selena Simone Fong. Samantha M. Seitz. Matthew S. Smith, Milan Sock, Christina Sum, Nathan T. Sum, Samantha Sum, Elena Song, Felix Song, Alina Y. Soto, Genesis B. Soto, Leandra M. Soto, Nicholas A. Sousa, Tanya M. Sousa, Darren K. Soy, Kenny V. Soy, Justin L. Saray, Ryan D. Stassi, Jordan D. Suarez, Taya M. Sullivan, Alexandra M. Serpernat, Caitlin M. Tangway, Austin J. Tedaronis, Kayla Y. Tejada, Marla Tech, Tiffany J. Tebow, Casey M. Torrigan, Jaylene M. Torres, Jesus Torres, Michelle Torres, Widalise Torres, Chow X. Tran, Jennifer Tran, Andrew J. Tricocci, Brianna Lynn M. Trottier, Holly J. Tugman, Nathan P. Taransky, Navi Toy, Sarah T. Tyler, Rebecca S. Va, Ingrid Valencia Gallego, Tyler J. Valentino, Enrique Valenzuela, Haley Vandersluis, Darren P. Vaughn, Marissa L. Vasquez, Shanika S. Venn, Dylan C. Verdi, Matthew G. Vieira, Lakeisha S. Vang, Emily K. Valaris, Chantita L. Vinn, Edward A. Vunn, Ritsathia V. Kaylee N. Wandell, Brandon J. Weisbach, Midori M. Whiting, James D. Williams, Victoria E. Wilson, Tyler A. Wood, Isis M. Woodson, Anthony B. Zazonkam, Borinthana P. U. Jasenia Zapata, Maria Alejandra Zapata Ochoa.
Thank you.
At this time, I'd like to call Lindisa Pohl up to the podium for a special presentation.
On behalf of the graduating class of 2015, I would like to thank two amazing people for their wonderful dedication throughout our senior year. Miss Branco and Miss Roy.
And now I'd like to ask Ms. Valerie Branco to come up and share a moment of reflection with the class of 2015. Ms. Branco.
Class of 2015, if you could stand so I can give the moment of reflection. Class of 2015, I stand before you not only as your advisor, but a former graduate of Greater Lowell Technical High School. Graduates, your journey has just begun. Stay focused on the future and set goals for yourself. You only have 52 years till retirement. As you make choices in life, remember these three things. Perseverance, no matter how hard it gets, stay focused on your goals. Motivation, push yourself to achieve greatness. And happiness, choose a career that makes you happy every single day. I leave you with this quote from Nikos Kazakowski: in order to succeed, we must first believe that we can. Congratulations to the class of 2015. You did it. Please stay standing as the dignitaries leave the stage. Thank you.